Peace, peace.
It's your man, Just Be Real, coming to you live once again. This is going to be part one on the AIDS virus is man-made. From here on out, the continuation of my video is going to be pretty much on speaking upon the AIDS virus. I'm done speaking upon the Bible, you know what I'm saying? All that shit is old news. It's not serving a purpose. This is something that should be talked about on an everyday basis. So, this is a website you can check out. It's called the Strecker Memorandum, right? I watched this video last night, and I purchased the book for like $2 on Amazon, packed with information. So it says a Strecker Memorandum, right? Now, I came about this guy's work through a book called The Secret Ancient Flower, right? This book is entitled, The Ancient Secret Flower, right? Okay, so this book is entitled How I Came About Through This Guy's Work. I was reading this book, The Ancient Secret of Life, The Ancient Secret of the Flower of Life, Volume 1. And I went to the part where it talked about here, the Strecker Memorandum on AIDS, right? Excuse me. And it says here that, bring this up. You to see this. He says, here is one last drama. Actually, there are many other political situations you can talk about, but he said, I'll say that for another day. So now he's talking about the AIDS virus. He says, I suggest you try to find the Strecker Memorandum material if you haven't read it or watched the video. I'm going to put it in my description box. So the governments are really trying to suppress it. Dr. Strecker made a video memorandum of what he believed happened around AIDS. He is a brilliant person. He has worked with retroviruses and is an expert on this subject. He showed a video on television and the governments threatened him. Who the governments? I show who the government is. Who's running this world? It says they allegedly killed his brother and a senator who was sponsoring it. But they didn't get Strecker. This man right here. It says here that would have been too obvious, I guess. It says Dr. Strecker has distributed many of his videos. He got them out to the world, though you don't know about it anymore. Dr. Strecker shows on film how the United Nations were trying to solve an environmental problem. They knew that the biggest environmental problem in the entire world was a human population. And at the rate it was going, the world would double its population by 2010 and 2012. But because of what the Chinese did, only allowing one child per couple and other strenuous work around the world, they slowed it down. But they believe that it's still going to happen. Alright? So they made the AIDS virus. Let's get to the good part. They made this virus of black people. Listen to this. Dr. Strecker showed scientifically exactly how the UN did it. They took a virus from a sheep and a virus from a cow and blended them together in a certain way to make the AIDS virus. But before they distributed it, they also made a cure for it. The governments have the cure right now, according to Dr. Strecker. The people who were doing this, and history will verify this, were obviously prejudiced because they single out two groups, the blacks and homosexuals. You see that? Now, it says, this is the most controversial video you ever see. Dr. Robert Strecker refutes with documented evidence virtually everything the so-called experts and government's report have told you about AIDS. He asserts in no uncertain terms that AIDS is a man-made disease. AIDS is not a homosexual disease. AIDS is not a venereal disease. AIDS can be carried by mosquitoes and there can never be a vaccine. Now give me 1 second. Even Chris Rock talks about it. This is critical. You need to know what your government has been doing to you. This is some fucked up ass shit. They don't like you black people. They're trying to eradicate your ass. I broke that shit down in my videos. That you know how the AIDS virus is made. It's not a homosexual disease. That's bullshit. They made this shit. They made this disease, this virus, for black folks and homosexuals. They made this disease for niggas. They trying to wipe out niggas. They don't give a shit about no fucking Bible. This is bigger than the goddamn Bible. This is bigger than any religious books. Now, let's go to this site right here. Dr. Kwame Natambu, Real Origin of AIDS and U.S. Tuskegee Experiment. So it says, since it has been decreed that the HIV/AIDS virus vaccine may not be found anytime soon, it is appropriate to decode, decipher, and delineate the real origin of this deadly disease. At the outset, it must be stated that the origin of AIDS is neither connected with the green monkey, African people, nor the Haitians. The stark reality is that according to the Strecker Memorandum in 1983, it says AIDS is a man-made disease, AIDS is not a homosexual disease, AIDS is not a venereal disease, AIDS can be carried by mosquitoes, Condoms will not prevent AIDS. There are at least 6 different AIDS viruses in the world. It says, it should be stated that all the various AIDS viruses are recombinant retroviruses, and that they have the ability to recombine with the genes of any cell they enter, and the offspring of new viruses they form are different from the parent viruses. Why and how was AIDS created? It says that the AIDS virus was created as a political, ethic weapon to be used mainly against blacks. Here are the sources. Fiedler said this shit in 1989. And the United States Control World Commission decreed that 2.7 billion non-white people must be eliminated from this planet by the year 2000. Turner said in 1991, AIDS is a biological warfare. Now check this out. This is the book that I purchased, right? When I read some of this shit, it had me in tears. And I said, this world is fucked up, and these white folks are sick and twisted. So I read some of this shit online. They didn't put the whole book online. They only put bits and pieces of it. give me 1 second. This is some heavy duty shit. See, if you don't know who and what God is, you don't know why the AIDS virus is made. Who it's for? I read this shit today, man, and I watched the video last night. I said these motherfuckers is crazy. These fuckers are crazy. Alright, so here's the book right here. Emerging Viruses, AIDS and Ebola, Nature, Accident or Intentional, Leonard G. Horovitz, right? And the book is only $6. And the book is like 500 some pages, right? You see it for yourself, it's 500 some pages. Now when you go online and you type this shit in on what's name, they're only gonna put up 127 pages. How come they are not putting out the whole book? Because they know this shit is true. This white man done broke the fucking barrier. I want you to see this shit. So here's the book right here. Let me show you. Right here. And you see they only have 127 pages of. So they made this disease for black folks. Alright? I want you to see this. I'm not making this shit up. Let's blow this shit up. Let's see. All these diseases are man-made. All of them. The measles, chicken pops, the chicken pox, the mumps, cancer, syphilis, all that shit is man-made. So it says here that the World Health Organization theory of AIDS. The World Health Organization, what they call it, WHO theory, festered in my mind like a disease. This is the author talking, right? And it says here that the AIDS virus was cultured as a biological weapon and then deliberately deployed was unfathomable. How could WHO, World Health Organization, scientists, and others in the United States Public Health Service consciously or even unwittingly create a such hideous germ? More incomprehensible was the alleged targeting of American homosexuals and black Africans for genocide. You see that? Are you seeing this? They made this virus for black folks. For niggas. This is bigger than the goddamn Bible. Fuck that book. God ain't cure no goddamn AIDS. I done told you who and what God is. Now let's keep on going. I'm gonna post this shit in my description, but I'm gonna come right back and make a part two. How come your camps is not talking about this shit? They want your money. Let's keep on going. So it says here that, according to Malcolm Turner, June 1991, and William Campbell Douglas, they said, AIDS is not an act of God against homosexuals. It did not appear out of thin air, and it did not come from Africa. It was designed to kill people of color, and a review of statistics show that this is exactly what is happening. The creation of the AIDS virus by the WHO, or the World Health Organization, was not a diabolical scientific exercise that got out of hand. It was a cold-blooded, successful attempt to create a killer virus, which was then used in a successful experiment in Africa. It says, the creation of AIDS was not an accident. It was deliberate. Real origin of AIDS. The AIDS virus was created by the United States government at Fort Detrick in Maryland, a biological warfare laboratory in building number 550 in the P4 lab. The sum of U.S. $10 million was requested by the Defense Department to build the lab under the House of Representatives bill number H.R. 15090 in the 91st Congress in 1970. The Streaker Memorandum, 1983. Now, when you go, now, if this shit don't tie into what I've been talking about in my videos, I don't know what else does. So if you go back to my channel, now check this out. I already broke down who the fucking government is. Who's Congress and all that shit. Go to my channel. Click on my videos. And go down to... Who else did that? Right here. Go to the Jewish people. The Jewish people run the United States government and watch Jewish Samuel Gompers exposes racist. So click on this video. And we're gonna go to what is that man's name? They came up with the exclusion act. You gonna see all this shit ties in together. Let's see. Where is that man's name, man? I should have brought this book with me. Oh, yeah, we finna get their ass. What is this dude's name? I watched this shit last night. I watched that video last night. That shit pissed me the fuck off. See, these motherfuckers, that's crazy. Okay. Let's see. Let's go back here. What is this guy's name at? What is this dude's name? He's a congressman. Now let's read this stuff. That's me talking.
Alright. Now check this out. So we're looking at Julius Kahn.
Julius Kahn. Okay, so let's go here to Julius Kahn. Julius Kahn. Congressman. Julius Kahn, congressman. This Jew. He's a Jew. Alright, he's a Jew. He's a congressman. And let's see.
U.S. House Representative from California's 4th District. Let's see. Republican. He came up with the Selective Service Act of your ass joining the Army, or if you did, your ass going to jail. I talked to this before. He had been reelected to the 69th Congress. Okay, so these are Jewish people that's doing this shit. I'm not making this shit up. See, you're going to see how this shit, all this shit ties in together. So it says that, let's see, in testimony during hearings before a subcommittee of the subcommittee on appropriations, House of Representatives, who was running the House of Representatives? Who was running the government? The fucking Jew. I told y'all that a thousand one times. So it goes on to say here that, give me 1 second. Oh, I'm coming back for part two, baby. I read this shit today. That shit pissed me off so bad. I say these motherfuckers is sick. Let's go. Okay, so let's go here. Let's go back. It says here that in testimony during hearings before a subcommittee on the Committee on Appropriations, House of Representatives, 91st Congress, First Sessions, Part 5, Dr. Donald MacArthur, Director of Advanced Research Project Agency, DOD, Department of Defense, presented evidence for the development of the AIDS virus on July 1st, 1969, as follows. It says, the dramatic progress being made in the field of molecular biology led us to investigate the relevance of this field of science to biological warfare. A small group of experts considered this matter and provided the following observations. All biological agents up to the present time are representatives of naturally occurring disease and are thus known to scientists throughout the world. They are easily available to qualified scientists for research, either for offensive or defensive purposes. Within the next 5 to 10 years, it would probably be possible to make a new effective microorganism which could differ in certain important aspects from any known disease-causing organisms. Most important of these is that it might be refractory and the immunological and therapeutic processes up to which we depend to maintain our related freedom for effective diseases. Infectious disease. Let's see here. Let's keep on going. This is a lot of stuff to read. There's a lot of stuff to read. I gotta maneuver back and forth. So let's go back to his site, right? I'm gonna post it in my description box. Let's see what this guy has to say. Let me skip some of this.
Retro in the jungles of Africa,
members of the research community and the government. Now, let's find out the truth about AIDS.
I'm Dr. Robert Strucker, a practicing internist and gastroenterologist in Los Angeles. I have a special interest in pharmacology, pathology, and now AIDS. I became interested in the AIDS question several years ago in doing a health maintenance proposal, basically an insurance proposal, for Security Pacific Bank, a bank here in California.
I keep on telling you all, they know who niggas are. It ain't got shit no got, and it got nothing to do with no damn Bible, no curses, none of that shit. If you niggas don't know who and what God is, hey, you gonna continue to be dumbasses.
More and more members of the medical and research community, such as Dr. Peter Duesberg, University of California at Berkeley, Dr. John Seale, a member of the Royal Society of Medicine of London, Dr. Alan Cantwell, who has recently finished a third book on AIDS, this one on the origin of AIDS, are questioning the validity of the popular view about AIDS, which has failed to scientifically explain the disease. So I've decided it's time that someone tells you the truth about AIDS. So in this program, I will show you how the AIDS virus was actually predicted, requested, produced, employed and now threatens the very existence of mankind because it works. To understand why I believe that the AIDS virus came out of a laboratory rather than out of the jungles of Africa, you have to understand several important concepts which I will address in the next few minutes. These concepts actually include an understanding of viruses, bacteria, human cell lines, tissue culture, and manipulation of all of those things in the laboratory. In the first question about the AIDS virus, in addressing what the AIDS virus is, the virus has a morphology, something of this form, which is actually a so-called D-type retrovirus. So what are viruses? Some people say that viruses are the smallest replicating microorganisms. Some people say that viruses are bad news in a sugarcoat. Actually, in the case of a retrovirus, the AIDS virus, which is R-E-T-R-O, retrovirus, what does this mean? Viruses in general are thought to be the smallest replicating organisms that require other cells to grow themselves in. Viruses are not capable of reproducing themselves on their own outside of living tissue, is the dogma of the scientists today. Viruses must inhabit another cell for eventual growth and reproduction. Bacteria, fungi, and some other organisms actually are capable of growing outside of tissue. In other words, they don't have to inhibit or inhabit other tissue to reproduce themselves. They can grow on tissue culture plates, such as bacteria. But viruses must grow inside of tissue, which requires that there be living human or animal tissue for them to replicate in. Now, if we look at the word retrovirus, we know that this is a small self, the replicating organism, which grows inside of living tissue.
We've all been taught about AIDS, but we were never taught that our own government made the shit. And they had targeted this weapon. They made this into a weapon, a biological weapon. And they targeted it at black people, Negroes, niggas.
Now, what does the term retro stand for? The term retro, in the case of this virus, stands for the fact that contained within the AIDS virus and other so-called...
YouTube might block this shit. They might strike my channel.
...called human retroviruses or other animal retroviruses are small enzymes known as reverse transcriptase. That is where the word retro comes from. The reverse transcriptase, which is the RE, comes from reverse...
This is dealing with your life. This is dealing with real life. We ain't talking no goddamn Bible, no fairy tale bullshit. How many people in your family you know has cancer? How many people in your family know might have the AIDS virus? How many people in your family you know might have sickle cell? Or they might have the measles or chickenpox? You know that shit is all man-made? Or polio. We've all experienced that shit as children. We've all had chickenpox as children. And the measles. Some people might have had the mumps. But where was all these fucking diseases that during slavery and back in ancient, so-called ancient times? Where was all these fucking diseases coming? Where was those diseases at? How come we didn't hear about known diseases in the Egyptian documents? With the Egyptians, or the Romans, or the Greeks, because it's all man-made, goddammit.
First, and the TRO comes from transcriptase. That is an enzyme in the AIDS virus which actually is responsible for duplication of the genes of the AIDS virus, which are in an RNA form, different than human form. Human genetic material is in a DNA form. So if the AIDS virus is to insert itself into human material, somehow after infection of the cell, what happens is this enzyme duplicates the RNA of the AIDS virus into a DNA form and actually inserts that into the human DNA. If you have an example, here's a cell, and inside this cell, here's the human DNA. What happens is the AIDS virus genes get in and are actually duplicated into DNA.
Let me pause it. Let's do some more reading. So it goes on to say that, let's see. It says here that, according to Health News Network, a history of secret human experiments, September 11, 2002, Let's see here. Let me scroll down here. This is a lot to read. Okay, so it says that in 1970, funding for the synthetic biological agent is obtained under H.R. 15090. The project, under the supervision of the CIA, is carried out by the Special Operations Division at Fort Detrick, a Army's top secret biological weapons facility. Speculation is raised that molecular biological techniques are used to produce AIDS like retroviruses. Again, in 1970, United States intensifies its development of the ethnic weapons. Military Review, November 1970, designed to selectively target and eliminate specific groups who are susceptible due to genetic deficits and variations in DNA. Now, what do we know about black folks, niggas? Our DNA is not of this world. I talked about this in my video on... watch my videos on Forbidden Archaeology Part 1 and Part 2. See, my videos tie in with real fucking life. Dr. Theodore Strecker, 1999, suggests that the U.S. National Cancer Institute, in collaboration with the World Health Organization, or the WHO, made the AIDS virus in their laboratories in Fort Detrick, now NCI. They combined the deadly retrovirus, bovine leukemia virus, and sheep vaccinia virus, and injected them into human tissue cultures. The result was the AIDS virus, the first human retrovirus known to man, and now believed to be 100% fatal to those infected. Dr. Strecker, 1989, further contends that AIDS could not have engineered itself. It was engineered in a laboratory by virologists. The record reveals that the World Health Organization, the WHO, vigorously, quote, called for scientists to work with deadly agents and attempt to make a hybrid virus that would be deadly to humans. An attempt should be made to see if viruses can in fact exert selective effects on immune function. The possibility should be looked at into that the immune response to the virus itself may be impaired if the infecting virus damages more or less selectively the cell responding to the virus. The AIDS epidemic was triggered by the mass vaccination campaign which eradicated smallpox. In fact, the WHO, or the World Health Organization, itself has studied new scientific evidence suggesting that immunization with the smallpox vaccine, Vaccinia, awakened the unsuspected dormant human immunodefense virus infection, HIV. In the words of an advisor to the WHO, they say, quote, I thought it was just a coincidence until we studied the latest findings about the reactions which can be used by the vaccinia. Now I believe the smallpox vaccine theory is the explanation to the explosion of AIDS. Let's see. Let's keep on going. There's a lot of information to take in. It's a lot of information to take in. This don't make no goddamn sense. This is bigger than the fucking Bible or any religious book. This is talking about real fucking life. I'll come back with a part two for your ass. Let's keep on going. Let's go back to the man's site. Let's see what he got to say. See, my shit ties in with real life. We ain't got time to be fucking around no goddamn Sabbath day and new moon and all that shit. We got bigger problems than some fucking Bible. And who the troll tribes all that. They don't give a shit about that. They trying to wipe your ass out. And they doing it.
...form copied by the reverse transcriptase. That information is then inserted into the genetic makeup of the human cell. This is now an AIDS virus residing in the human genes.
This is science. This is life. This is a matter of life and death. The Bible can't save you.
Which then...
They got the cure. They have the cure for it, because even in this book right here, emerging viruses, AIDS, and Ebola, they bring up the woman Henrietta Lacks. I talked about Henrietta Lacks in my video. They found her immortal line, her cells were immortal. She had the first immortal cell lines, meaning that her genes, her DNA, was recessive to viruses. And they patented her ass. This is not no fucking joke. This ain't no fucking game. This is matter of life and death. Keep fucking around. Don't say I ain't warn you.
Sends out a signal for production of a new AIDS virus. So, the RNA is the genetic information of all retroviruses. It's copied into the DNA formed by the reverse transcriptase, inserted into the genes, and subsequent production of new virus.
To better understand this subject and to help us appreciate the importance of Dr. Strecker's work, I'm going to briefly clarify and emphasize some of the information in this presentation. Virology is the study of viruses, deals with tiny living organisms visible only with the use of the most powerful electron microscopes. In fact, hundreds of thousands of AIDS viruses can easily fit on the head of a pin. What makes the AIDS virus particularly deadly is its ability to not only invade and neutralize human cells, but the virus's ability to put its own genetic material inside the human cell's genetic structure, thereby allowing the virus to use the human cell as a kind of virus factory, reproducing more viruses from the human cell's raw materials. Unlike larger organisms like...
I remember in my lessons, on my lessons for Forbidden Archaeology Part 1 and Part 2, we talked about genetic engineering. Somebody made white people. So now somebody has taken that concept and reverse engineered it. Let's keep on going. Let's go back into this book right here. Let's bring this up some. Okay. Let's see. So it says that in this book right here. And it says in this book right here that I'm about to come back and make a part two to this. Bring this up some. Okay. So it says the World Health Organization. Okay, I read that part already. It says frightening by the ramification of such alleged atrocities. I spent months in living in the now. As a behavioral scientist, I was no stranger to the subject of man's inhumanity towards man. I just feared what further research might reveal. Eventually, curiosity wore down my defense. And I attempted on several occasions to contact Dr. Robert Strecker, that guy we were watching, for an explanation. For months then, the telephone number I had for him rang continuously, unanswered. He says, secretly I was thankful. The secondary source of information I had about this Strecker memorandum were adequate for my needs. I rationalized. The few documents I had on the WHO theory of AIDS came from a holistic physician I met at a National Wellness Association conference. For years, the doctor documented the... doctors, the AIDS virus. Right? Now, let's go down here. And it says, please wake up. And it says here that, let's see. It says the WHO, the World Health Organization, Strecker noted, also launched a major African campaign against smallpox in 1977, which involved the urban population, not to the rural pygmies. Had the, quote, green monkey been responsible for AIDS? Strecker professed the pygmies of rural Africa would have had a higher incidence of AIDS than the country's urban problems. The opposite is true. It says here that the fact of the matter is that the decision makers at WHO concluded that in the relation to the immune response, a number of useful experimental approaches can be visualized. As a result, they suggest that a neat way to do this would be to put their new killer virus, AIDS, into a vaccination program, sit back and observe the results. The WHO used smallpox vaccine as their vicious vehicle to spread the AIDS virus, and the geographic areas they chose were Uganda and the other African countries, Haiti, Brazil, and Japan. The present AIDS epidemic coincides with these geographic areas. The stark reality is that AIDS virus must be man-made and a bioengineered virus. According to Dr. Strecker, who unraveled this conundrum, the greatest murder myth of all time, says, quote, "If the African gray monkey could transmit AIDS to humans, the present known amount of infection in Africa makes it statistically impossible for a single episode, such as a monkey biting someone, to have brought this epidemic to the point. The doubling time of the number of people infected, about every 14 months, when correlated with the first known case and the present known number of cases, proved beyond a doubt that a large number of people had to have been infected at the same time. Starting in 1972, when the first case from our mythical monkey and doubling the number infected from that single source every 14 months, you only get a few thousand cases. From 1972 to 1987, it is a 15-year or 180 months. If it takes 14 months to double the number of cases, then there would have been 13 doublings, one, then two, then one, then two, the four, then eight, etc. It says that the fact of the matter is that the global pandemic suggests that AIDS is expected to kill more people and orphan more children than all the wars of the 20th century combined. Federal Information System Corporation, 1990. So they took a sheep and a cow, mix those two viruses together, and that's how you get the AIDS virus. Okay, let's go back at this man's site.
Like bacteria, viruses do not respond to conventional medical treatment, much like the common cold virus cannot be treated effectively by drugs.
Now, how does this AIDS virus, which is a human retrovirus of the D type, how does this virus affect humans? Basically, the immune system of humans is broken down into two parts. It's very simple. One is called B cells and one is called T cells. B cells are derived from the bursa fabricis, but the easy way to remember B is that they control basically production of antibodies and control bacterial infections. Therefore, B rather than bursa, you can think of it as bacteria. T cell systems control opportunistic infections such as pneumocystis carinii pneumonia, the production of cancers like Kaposi sarcoma, and other microorganisms such as tuberculosis. So that if you wiped out the T cell system, you could see the arisal of opportunistic infections such as pneumocystic carinii pneumonia, a hallmark of AIDS, Kaposi sarcoma, an alleged sarcoma, another hallmark of AIDS, or other diseases. If you wiped out the B system, you would have trouble protecting yourself against bacteria and perhaps in developing antibodies. Now, in the case of the AIDS virus, once it infects the human body, selectively destroys the T4 cells of the human body. The T4 cells are a division of the T lymphocytic system, the one that helps us control cancers, fungi,
pneumocystis crini pneumonia, and other organisms. The AIDS virus selectively leads to the destruction of those cells. If you look at the overall incidence of these new so-called human retroviruses, you'll discover the following. First, there is HTLV-1, a new human retrovirus which is responsible for T-cell leukemia. There is HTLV-2, which has this appearance, which is responsible for the development of hairy cell leukemia. And we have HTLV-3, which looks like this. These are the best known so far, which is the AIDS virus, responsible for AIDS. Now, interestingly enough, when you put these viruses into tissue culture, what happens? This virus is proliferative in tissue culture. It makes things grow. It's not surprising, therefore, that you might see the arisal of a T-cell leukemia.
So the AIDS virus is not a homosexual disease. The government, your government, made that disease. Who did they make it for? Niggas, black folks, and homosexuals. But the majority, the virus is made for niggas. I'm going to pause this video. I'm going to come back and make a part two. And let's read a little bit more. All right? And let's see here. So what did they discover? Okay. It says here that right there in the medical literature for anyone to read for themselves was basically proof that the AIDS virus and pandemic were actually predicted years ago by world-famous virologists, among others. They found that top scientists writing in a bulletin of the World Health Organization were actually requesting that AIDS-like viruses be created to study the effects on humans. So who are the real humans? Black folks, niggas. Go back and watch my videos on Forbidden Archaeology Part 1 and Part 2. All this shit is going to tie in together. All of it. Okay? Let's go back. And it says in that, let's see. In fact, the Strecker's unearthed thousands of documents all supporting the man-made origin of AIDS. Meanwhile, the government was telling everyone that a green monkey in Africa bit some native and started AIDS. Now this is the type of shit they pull. So what they try to do is they try to get our ass with this type of shit. If you ever seen that movie called Outbreak, I think this is what the AIDS virus is really about. This movie called Outbreak, when that monkey comes from over there and it's infected with a virus, and people start getting sick. So it says Outbreak is a 1995 American medical disaster film directed by, okay, blah 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 blah. Let's go to the plot. So here's your monkey. Are you seeing how this shit is tying in together? That can't trick my ass. I know how to piece this shit together. Let's go to the goddamn plot. You want the plot, goddammit. This shit should piss you off. Especially if you a nigga. If you a black person. Your government, these fuckers you put in office, these motherfuckers created a fucking deadly biological weapon to wipe your asses off the face of this goddamn earth. Let's see. It says Betsy, a white-headed monkey that is host to the virus, is smuggled into the country. James Jimbo Scott, a worker at an animal test laboratory, is infected when he steals Betsy to sell on the black market. That's dumb fucker. Let's see here. So you dealing with virologists, right? So it says the plot. In 1967, a virus called Motamba, which causes a deadly fever, is discovered in the African jungle. Now this shit sounds just like what we just read with the goddamn virus. They say the shit started with a goddamn monkey. Let's go back here. They say that
Meanwhile, the government was telling everybody that a green monkey in Africa bit some native and started the AIDS virus. This shit sound like this goddamn movie. Let's go back. A deadly fever is discovered by an African jungle. To keep the virus a secret, U.S. Army destroyed a camp where soldiers were infected. Okay, blah, blah, blah. Let's see here. They say this virus started with a goddamn monkey. And this white male trying to smuggle the shit in into the States. So look at it. It says the film released on March 1995 was a box office, blah, 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 blah. It says a real-life outbreak of the Ebola virus was occurring in Zambia when the film released. They're telling you right here in movie format. But they can't give you the whole goddamn thing. The film focuses on an outbreak of a fictional Ebola-like virus. Who made this goddamn Ebola virus? The goddamn government. They're telling you right in your goddamn face. Ebola virus. Let's go back here. I'm coming back and making part two to this shit. Let's go back. It says here that as their research continued, it became obvious for the documentation that the virus itself was not only created as requested, but actually deployed. And now threatens the existence of mankind because it does what it was designed to do. It does what it was designed to do. It caused cancer in humans via a contagious virus. Eventually, the Strekkers came to realize everything the government, the so-called AIDS experts, and media were telling the public were not only misleading, but out and out lies. The truth of the matter is, AIDS is the man-made disease, okay, and things like that. The scariest part, it says, the most dreaded fear that all oncologists or cancer doctors, virologists, and immunologists live with is that someday cancer, in one form or another, will become a contagious disease, transferable from one person to the other. AIDS has now made the fear a reality. If you think you are safe because you are not gay or promiscuous, or because you are not sexually active, then you must watch this video carefully. It goes on to say that, I'm about to make a part two to this. The most common misconception being fostered upon us right now concerning sexual active Americans. We are told that if a man uses a condom, the transference of a deadly virus is virtually eliminated. Nothing is further from the truth. Of all the body fluids that the AIDS virus is found in, semen contains the least. As a matter of fact, in every single study ever published on the subject, no one has found a significant amount in anyone's semen. It just isn't there in huge numbers. Now I'm going to come back and make a part two to this shit. I'm gonna come back and make a part two to this. So you got the biological attack alert. Right? Biological attack alert. And let's see here. All these diseases are man-made. And who's making these diseases? The white man. It ain't niggas, because they're telling you clear as day that when you go back here, in the introduction of this book, they tell you clear as day that the virus is made for black folks, for niggas. Let's see. The polio virus that was made by oh my God, man. Let's see. Bring this out some. Yeah, I'm about to make a part two to this.
Part 1, Introduction and Scientific Background, Chapter 1, The World Health Organization, Theory of AIDS. The World Health Organization theory festered in my mind like a disease. He said that the AIDS virus was a culture as well as a that the AIDS virus was a culture as a biological weapon and then deliberately deployed was unfathomable. How could World Health Organization and others in the United States Public Health Service consciously or even unwittingly create a hideous germ? More inconceivable was the alleged targeting of American homosexuals and black Africans for genocide. Genocide. You know what genocide means? It means they want your ass wiped off the face of this goddamn earth. The AIDS virus is made for black folk, for niggas. Now, stay tuned for part 2. This is the AIDS virus part 1. I'm going to post these links in my description box. Peace.